Bad news. And below all of this is kind of an ulcerated, irritated, inflamed, sore skin. And I'm leaving the stuff that's really, really firmly adhered for right now. I'm thinking what we want to do with this little bunny is give something to help with pain. Where'd he come from?
We got a call yesterday. These people were trying to catch him and asking for our help. They caught the bunny and then Joe was able to pick him up.
We'll take a look at him under the microscope too and see if we see anything interesting there. The appropriate interval for giving these injections is 2 weeks because, you know, in any kind of active ear mite infection, you've got adults and pre-adults and eggs. And so you kill off all the adults because they're feeding off of these sebaceous secretions in the ear through which that ivermectin enters the ear canal. So those guys are killed off within about 48 hours of the injection. And then 2 weeks later, those pre-adults and perhaps a new hatch has come to light. And so we hit them again with another dose of ivermectin, wipe those bad boys out. And then on really bad infestations, you kind of assume there may be a few eggs left on visit two that are going to hatch out yet again. So that third visit is sort of hedging your bets to make sure you don't have a recurrence. They tend to be spread more by direct contact. If you've got a bunny over here in this corner of the room and another one in a hutch on this side of the room, these ear mites are not going to jump off the bunny and make the trek all the way to the other side of the room and get on that other bunny. So they got to be within fairly close proximity of one another to give them to one another. I've seen bunnies that are strictly indoors, never get outside, single household bunnies, and they've been in the house for 3 or 4 years, never had ear mites before, all of a sudden show up with ear mites. And the only thing that I can figure on those guys is that the owner may be bringing them home in bedding or hay that they purchased at the local feed store or local pet store. And a lot of times you've got your bunny display here. All the bunnies are in a big, huge cage. And they've all got ear mites, or some of them may have. And then right under the cage, here's a nice storage space where you can keep all the shrink-wrapped hay and the shrink-wrapped bedding that you might buy for them. And if that stuff is not really impervious to contamination, then you may take home contaminated bedding or hay, and then lo and behold, that single household bunny ends up getting ear mites.
One injection is to kill the ear mites.
One is an anti-inflammatory. Just give one time to kind of settle these ears down, make them less red, inflamed, irritated, painful. And then we're doing this antibiotic to also kill any secondary bacterial infection that's causing ear problems. What I gave today should last about 48 hours. And then at that point, ears ought to be settled down. They ought to be less painful. And that antibiotic is also going to be kicking in. And so I think we're in pretty good shape doing that, especially since we don't know much about this bunny and he's a little bit small. Most of the oral pain medications that people use for rabbits have potential to cause some problems with kidneys and possibly liver, and so we don't want to throw the baby out with the bathwater. Good now. It's nice as a veterinarian to occasionally have something work and have your patients actually get better and heal. We've had a pretty good day today. All right, this is the last installment of the ivermectin. Okay, sweetness. Are you ready? Left side looks great. I mean, we had little ear mite superhighways and condominiums and skyscrapers and the whole nine yards in that ear. Three injections, good to go. Now Parker is a wonderful bunny because he's not dealing with bunny angst from bilateral infestation, the dreaded ear mite. When you got ears like that, you don't want mites in them. So that's my story and I'm sticking to it.